Hi, this is Beatrice with Parole Amate, and because we're at the letter U, and perhaps because of Thanksgiving's complicated history, I have been thinking about the word or the verb usurpare, which is like to usurp. Usu, by usage, rapere, which, you know, is also the root of to rape. So to make your own something that's not supposed to be your own. And I guess in the case of Italy, I mean to talk about the usurping of certain African, important African countries. That is something that usually gets minimized. For example, the time frame that we always concentrate in is around fascist time, which was, of course, was a very painful time for colonialism, but it's much earlier, sort of the late 19th century, that Italy, maybe sort of last minute compared to other European nations, but not really, decides to want to be part of this game of European nations with murder technology that each had available and could employ in countries like certain countries of Africa. And oftentimes when we study these actions and these wars and this pain in school, the words were always nice. It was espansione, expansion, campagne, campaigns, even building together, construction, this idea of not quite, you know, of not quite being at fault, perhaps a self-forgiveness. So these comments that you still hear, my father would still say, oh, but we were nothing like the English. This myth of the Italian jolly character, it's this disorganization, even the instinct to sometimes collaborate or eat or bring pasta instead of work. Like, this is a little bit of mythology. And because perhaps Italy itself has been conquered time and again in prior times, this wish to remain the underdog. Of course, we can see, you know, I'm in front of the map, and little Italy up here. We got Libya at a certain point, Northern Africa, and then Eritrea and Ethiopia. Of course, right now there is a big conflict right there, and Somalia. And Ethiopia is like the second largest country in Africa. So minimization feels a little disingenuous. It was thanks to Clarissa Klo, who's head of European studies at San Diego State University, that I got introduced to writer and singer Gabriella Ghermandi. She's an Italian-Ethiopian artist who, in her books, the one I've read is called Regina di Fiori e di Perle, the Queen of Flowers and Pearls. It's also translated in English, and it sort of gives her experience as someone born of an Ethiopian mother and Italian father right after World War II, and or in the time still of colonialism. And what I notice is that a typical phenomenon that I can see even really between San Diego and Tijuana, in a way, the colonizer or the richer party, or let's say the colonizer, can ignore the colonized, but not vice versa. And there's this mention of Talian Sollato, which was perhaps in Amharic, that's the language in Ethiopia, way of saying Italian soldier, and sort of seeing this presence, this very heavy presence. And then perhaps on a lighter note, and thinking of stories of migration, you know, we'll touch on another thing that Gabriella spoke about when she came to visit in San Diego. And she, the premise is that once I and my friends moved from Italy, we would spend a lot of time saying, oh, wow, a Californian culture is so individualistic. It's quite hard to make, for example, to turn your neighbors into acquaintances. And, you know, how do you make community? That was the refrain. When Gabriella, as a teenager, moves from Ethiopia to Bologna, Italy, which is even considered a very warm and jolly town in northern Italy, she notices how neighbors would indeed look into each other's windows and spaces, but from a distance, but then on the street, they wouldn't really acknowledge each other or actually engage in any deep way. And her memory from her town was of kids being able to go in and out of homes, of neighbors. There was this implicit making of community that, and then there was coldness, right? And I just sort of love this idea, this perspective, right? This different perspective and what you come from and what you come to expect and what you think is, what gives you warmth. And perhaps this touches too on privacy, which is not a word that exists in Italian, right? We borrow the English privacy, that's what we say. Yeah, so I don't mean to go back to the P, we're almost towards the Z, but so I will see you next Monday for the letter V. Thank you for being here.